Good morning or afternoon. My name's Cameron. I like to talk about stuff that I like. Today I'm going to talk to you about a new Obsidian plugin, newish. There was a thread on the Obsidian forums about it, and basically it's a new journaling daily notes app that is based off of or inspired by Diarium, which is for iOS, macOS, Windows, and Android. And it is a kind of a all-encompassing, you know, journaling app. We've got a plugin for Obsidian called Diarian by github.com/erally. You can also find it in the Obsidian third-party community plugins interface there. You can install it through there. And so what are some of the features of this? What's so cool about it? Well, get a calendar view, which there's already a couple calendar plugins that work with your daily notes to varying degrees. But this one's a little different. It comes with some other stuff that I'll show you. It's a little bit, it's got more pizzazz. An on this day feature, this review pane that will show you stuff from previous daily notes, lets you take a look at it. And then if you have already been using the main app Diarium, you can import your data from there into the plugin. You can also, there's some ratings that you can do, so you can rate your days in whatever context you want. You can insert a timestamp into the active note, which you could do with like templater and you know, setting up a hotkey or something. So this isn't like super cool, but it's already done for you and it looks pretty nice. My favorite thing is that it supports multiple notes per day, and I'll show you how that kind of manifests and how you can access them through the calendar. Yeah, and then nested daily notes, if you like to have your daily notes in like a year folder, then a month folder, you know, then a week folder or what have you, it can deal with stuff like that as well. Let's take a quick look at the settings. So once you've got it installed and enabled, you've got a few different options in here. Open new daily notes in live preview reading or source mode. So you can choose the default that your notes open up in. You can change the calendar type. So if you've got a non-standard calendar or something like that, you can figure that out. Disable future dates so you can make it so you can't make a daily note for a future day, which you might want to do, for example, if you want, oh, well, I've got an event that day. Let me, let me make a daily note for that day. Put in the event data, whatever, in there. This will disable you from doing that. You can change the heading format, which is going to be this right here underneath the calendar, how that is presented. Banner images, you can add leaf location. So this is where the calendar opens up. So you can have the calendar open up in its own tab. Right now I've got it in the sidebar, so we'll play with that for a bit. I'll show you the tab later though. Open on startup, yes or no. So on this day, what's the age of notes that you want to pop up in the review panel? Do you want to get notifications for it? They've got pop-up modal and notice. Notice is the upper right little, like, you know, default kind of baked-in Obsidian notice that you might get from plugins and stuff. And then pop-up modal is a big old window that goes up at the front, of just like in the center of your Obsidian screen. Again, open and startup, yes or no. Note previews, that's going to be these little things underneath the calendar I'm going to show you. Timestamp, so by default, this is going to be, actually, I might have changed that. In fact, I'm pretty sure I did. But that's a timestamp that I'll just enter in there, and that is just a command palette entry that you can, type in and search through the command palette or set up as a hotkey or whatever you want to do. Then the rating system. You can set the maximum that you can rate it. So you can have it 10, you can have it out of 7, you can have it out of 3, whatever you want, whatever makes sense for you. You can change what it's called. So the rating is basically just read from a front matter key. And then filled rating item. So we've got a star here that's fully colored, and we got a kind of an outline of a star there. And then you can see how that will appear right there. And you can change that to whatever you want. All right, so what does it look like? How does it work? Well, we've got the calendar open right here. So I've made some daily notes. That's the ones with the little dots there. If there's multiple dots, that means there's multiple daily notes. So if we go in and we click on here, click on September 10th, we've got the entry there with a little image there. And if we click again on it towards like the header, it'll pop up in our main Obsidian window here. And as you can see, we got a cute ass little bun bun here with a little bow tie. And that image is reflected on the calendar. So if you do put images in your daily notes, they're going to kind of pepper the calendar, which I quite enjoy. I like that a lot. It helps me, find older days easy. You can pretty quickly hop back there if you know, oh yeah, I did something that day, so there's some images there or something. If we go here, changes here, we click it, open it up, boom, we got a little screenshot I took. So pretty nice. I like that aspect a lot. I also just like the appearance of the calendar. If we click on this one, October 1st, we've got the two notes. We got two dots there, and we got two separate little boxes right here, right? So if I click on this one, we're going to have the daily note pop up in the main section again. If I click on here, it's going to swap to the other one. So how does that work exactly? So there is a kind of an extra set of settings for you, and that's the core daily notes. So in the daily notes setting, some of that stuff is going to be inherited and used by the Diarian plugin. So we've got the date format here, which is going to be year, month, day, and then hour, minute, second. And then the folder that they go in, dailies. I added the hour, minute, second. When you do that, and you can format it however you want, but there needs to be something that will change the file name. If you have just the date there and that's it, the multiple notes aren't really going to work. You need to have something that's going to make it make the file name different. And so you HHMMSS, hour, minute, second, and then that will be used to determine how many daily notes you have on a given date. And so like let's click here. If I click the little plus, we're going to get a pop-up that's going to say date, and it's going to be defaulted to whatever date you clicked on in the calendar, but you can change that. The time is going to be the current time, and again, you can change that. And if you're doing a previous day, obviously changing that might make a difference. And then template, if you click here, you can set a default template, and then you can see I've got work, project, and personal. So you've got different templates set up for different daily notes. That template just has the call out up here. Let me do another one, and we'll do a work one, create note, and you can see it's just got another call out here, and then you can start typing and do whatever you want, and that'll give you these call outs just right here as well in the little mini excerpts. I love how it handles the multiple daily notes. Multiple daily notes is something that I enjoy. I prefer having splitting up different sections of my day in whatever way makes sense through multiple notes rather than one giant daily note. But, different stuff is gonna, different people like different things. Boom. So now we've got it in the tab itself. Again, if we click here, we get the little excerpts, a daily note open, and I go to the command palette. Let's just filter through all the Diarian ones, right? So we've got select view, insert rating. You know what? Look at that bunny. That's a 4 if I ever saw it. And then down here, right by my head, you can see we've got the rating that's listed right in the little status bar there. And you can even click the status bar and it'll pop up the rating dialog again, and you can change it however you want. Open calendar, open importer. Again, if you have used the app that this is inspired from, you can move your journal over into here. New daily note, it's going to bring up that same exact pop-up from before. And right here, we got next daily note, and there's also a previous daily note. Next daily note, and it's going to automatically hop over to the next one. So we're right here. We were at the bun bun. Now we're at the screenshot one. I love that. My only, I guess, complaint, in quotes, it's not really a complaint, it's just a little suggestion. So like this will change the month. This will change the year. Very nice. Give me like an arrow here and an arrow here to go and cycle through daily notes. Something I can click to just cycle through. That'd be nice. All right. So the other thing that this one will do is It's got the on this day panel, and then you can see 12 months ago, I've got a daily note from 2023. Just the same, you can click it just like anything else. You get that there. You know, and like I mentioned in the settings, you can kind of change how this works and what time frames it looks at to resurface old notes to you, which is cool, which is nice, which is something that a lot of people I've seen on their daily note templates will do with data view and stuff like that. And this is just a core built-in thing of the plugin, which is cool. It won't put them like inside of every note. You know, if you do like a data view thing in your template, you can go back to any note and get links to previous, you know, year, last month, whatever notes you want. This doesn't put anything in the daily notes, so that may or may not be a plus for you. It just kind of depends on your thinking on that. I like the calendar in the little sidebar. I think it's great. And so that's a brief look at Diarian by Erica Gozer. GitHub.com/eRally. One might say it is an all-in-one journaling toolkit. I think it's very cool for my money. I think it's my favorite daily notes, but you know, it's got a little bit more pizzazz. I like that. Pizzazz goes a long way for me personally. Let's just bring up how am I feeling right now? I'm feeling about a 4 out of 5 on that one. 4 out of 5 right now. That's good. All right. Hope you guys are feeling 5 out of 5 or something. Yeah, go check it out, Diarian. All right. Goodbye.